Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. Just want to give a quick update. I'll be in North Carolina extra week. As the Bible says, as Joseph told his brothers, what the enemy meant for evil, God has turned into good. The enemy meant to do me harm, do me evil, but the Lord turned it around because it was right on time, as the Lord told me he would answer my prayer by close of business on Wednesday for a vehicle. And just as I called someone on the phone and was telling them, hey, I'm not going to be able to come over there and visit with you because I've got to go hunting for a vehicle. And as I was talking to them, brothers and sisters, a vehicle showed up in their driveway for me to use. And brothers and sisters, I will be driving that vehicle temporarily until the Lord's going to give me something better. I'll be driving the RV that I had before. If you guys have been watching my videos last August, someone gave me an RV to use. Now I've got the RV back. And that RV is actually in a little bit of a video I made about a storm. I made a video last August of a storm cloud that looked like a dragon over Winston-Salem here, Winston-Salem, North Carolina, when I got back from the Philippines last year. And that RV is just in that video. It's like a full-size Chevy van, conversion van. So it's kind of like, if people see it, I don't know if you want to, it's classified, I guess, as an RV or a conversion van, whatever. So I've got that back, and I'll be driving that. It's just right on time. As you know, I'd pressed the Lord and told the Lord I couldn't wait any longer. I was going to go buy a vehicle, and the Lord made a way. So I got this vehicle, and I'll be using that RV. It's kind of like a big sailboat trying to drive. It reminds me of the song that I listened to back when I was in the world. But I think it's by the B-52s. Love Shack, you know, that thing really sets sail. It is as big as a whale, and it does set sail when you drive it. But, you know, it's something to drive, and I think Sister Elaine, who also does the website for Church of the Firstborn, I invite you to visit there. Brother Sid down in South Carolina is a moderator. We have a chat thing on there, and we've been talking about going live with the chat. We've been talking about doing a radio show. I've been talking about embedding videos on there. Haven't done that. So Sister Elaine is going to be here next week, and we're going to meet. We're going to talk about the minivan I've been driving. She's going to get that, and we will discuss and take it back to where she's from, and then we will discuss about the website, what we can do to it and expand it. As a matter of fact, I would just mention, I had about 5 or 6 people volunteer to help me with the website before, and Sister Elaine is very busy. She has lots of other things. She's you know, she's got all kinds of things going on. She's a very busy person, like me. And if anyone else, or maybe the people that did before, if someone would come back and if you see this, who would like to help me to take the website to the next level, because I'm back in the States now. I mean, that's what's kept us from doing it. That we can put some kind of a vlog on there or whatever. I could do a daily video instead of YouTube, put it also on there. Maybe and do something with the chat room, and maybe even some kind of a radio show. And Brother Sid, he'll be the one that will be working with the web designer, and then with me to advance, you know, so we can make it more that it would attract people who need to go there, who need help. We got different departments on the churchofthefirstborn.com, churchfirstborn.com. The link is below this video. If you go down below this video and click the See More, it'll open up, and it's down there, churchfirstborn.com. And we have different ministries, like New Christian Ministry, former alcoholic, drug addict, like abortion recovery or something like that, you know, all these different kind of areas. We've got brothers and sisters, prayer warriors. We take prayer requests. I've got like 12, I think, if that's including me or not. Maybe I have 13 or 14, counting me. Prayer warriors, you send in a prayer request. It's sent out to all those people. And then we can also message you back. You can email with us, or those who are, it's kind of like their area. If you have if you're a woman and you got a problem, a woman type of deal, like I said, abortion, sexual abuse, whatever. You know, we have women who have either experienced that, or who are elders in the body of Christ, who will be glad to, you know, to mentor you and help you in those areas, to pray with you. You know, so God has provided us all those things, and just for whatever reason, God hasn't had us using that too much. You know, now that I'm back in the States, I hope we can use it. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I got the RV to roll, to head on down that highway, but I'm not going to Atlanta. I don't know what it is, brothers and sisters, but I think every single person that has contacted me from Atlanta, there seems to be some kind of issue with me in Atlanta. I don't know what it is with the people down there, or me. I don't know what it is. It seems to be a misconnect. I'm trying to think if there's somebody from Atlanta who I've talked to who it turned out to be a good thing. I don't know what it is, but I guess maybe the Lord doesn't want me to go to Atlanta. I don't know. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I don't know exactly what I'm going to do. The Lord, I haven't mentioned this in the video, I don't think. The Lord told me to go to Little Rock, Arkansas, which is a place I would never go to stay. But the Lord told me to go to Little Rock, Arkansas. And He's got something for me to do there, brothers and sisters. So I will not pass go. I will not collect $200. I will go to Little Rock, Arkansas. And then I don't know how long I'll be there, for how many days. And by the grace of God, if I can, I will stop in Nashville on the way. I will announce it. That'll be after next week. I'll go to Little Rock, and then I will be going to Dallas. And somewhere in between there, the Lord will give me the word, or the capability, either to drive this RV up to Seattle, or He'll want me to fly or whatever, I don't know. But I know the Lord, has a great plan. As the Lord has told me, brothers and sisters, the other day, the reason why I'm in the RV, before I got the RV, the Lord told me that, someone was being disobedient to the Lord. And, that happens. The Lord just tells us to do stuff and then people don't do it, even myself. It's someone else's blessings being held up by our disobedience. As an example, the Lord told me to go to Little Rock. Now, if I didn't go to Little Rock, there's someone's blessing that's going to be missed. I'll be in disobedience. The Lord had to get somebody else, or the person's blessing will be delayed or whatever. And that's true. As a matter of fact, as an example, I was telling my wife before we met, I owned a house before I went to the Philippines and here in North Carolina. And the Lord had told me 2 or 3 years before I moved to the Philippines, He told me, He showed me putting a for sale by owner sign in the front yard, and someone would come and buy the house the day I put the sign in the yard. And I put the sign in the yard, and then nobody came. So I was like, well, I don't know what's going on, Lord. And it was like a month later or 6 weeks later, a guy shows up to my house, an old hardshell Baptist, a Southern Baptist. His first name was Buck. I can't ever forget his name, because he had said, Buck. His name was Buck. his name was Buck. Last name started with an H. I can't ever forget his name because the way he talked. And anyway, brothers and sisters, he showed up to my house and he said, well, he asked me, I started talking to him, and I told him, yeah, that I'm getting ready to go to the Philippines. I'm trying to sell my house so I can move to the Philippines. And he was like, that's what it is. I knew something was going on. I didn't know what it was. I was like, well, what's wrong? He said, I saw you the day you were putting the sign in your front yard. And, now he's a Southern Baptist guy, and the Lord didn't speak to him too much. But he said the Lord spoke to him in his heart that day, go buy that house right now. Today I want you to buy that house. And he didn't do it. He disobeyed the Lord. And the Lord just stayed on him and stayed on him and stayed on him. Like 6 weeks later, he came back and bought the house. And then I got the price that the Lord told me at that time also, what exact price I would get. It was a fair price. It was a fair average price for what the house was worth. I probably could have got more, but the Lord gave me a price. That's the price that we got to. With really no negotiations. So thank the Lord for that. And anyway, brothers and sisters, that's just an example, where we can not be in the will of God and not obey the Lord and delay somebody else's blessing. So that's why it's critical that we obey the Lord, myself included. And the Lord told me to go to Seattle, but I don't know when, but He told me to go to Little Rock. And I believe the most important thing I need to do right now is go to Little Rock, brothers and sisters. So after this week, after I get everything settled, with the vehicles and my wife's, I don't think I mentioned, I made another video and I decided not to load it. I'm remaking it. My wife got her learner's permit this week. And then we have to wait so many days it will be delivered, now, because it has to go through Homeland Security. That's another part of Big Brother. North Carolina is one of those states that has sold out lock, stock, and barrel to the New World Order. So any driver's license or learner's permit, it has to go through some kind of Homeland Security thing. I know lots of states are probably doing that. North Carolina is a historically classic follower state, not a leader state. And I just want to give that. The Lord gave me a word just the other day about that. I want to say that because the Lord kept telling me to go to Little Rock, and I was like, Lord, I want to go to Texas. And the Lord is leading me, up there toward Arkansas. And I don't know if I'll live there, but it seems maybe that I will make my home base in Arkansas. And I was like, Lord, I want to go to Texas. Texas is the Lone Star State. Texas is like, was an independent country, And the Lord told me, that day that I was talking to the Lord about it was the day that Governor Perry said that he would not shake Obama's hand. And then later on when Obama showed up, he's taking a selfie with Obama. If you saw that, just a few weeks ago when Obama was up there in Dallas and, and all that. So, and then the headline I saw was Perry, you know, reneges on his promise not to shake Obama's hand. And so the Lord used that because the Lord told me Texas will be the first place that the New World Order will go, because Texas is known for being resistant and to being against the man. So the first place the man's going to go is to the strongest place and knock down the alpha male, and then everybody else is going to follow in behind. So you got like the tradition of South Carolina as an example in Texas. So the first place the devil's going to go is to take down Texas. And then what the Lord gave me, two signs and two witnesses that Texas was not going to stand against the New World Order. And they were both Governor Perry. First, he did that. The headline that day was that Perry reneges on promise not to shake Obama's hand. And then the second one was Gardasil. The Lord gave me the word Gardasil. So when I looked that up and saw that Governor Perry, one of his associates, one of his assistants, had all this money in the, you know, drug company, and then he signed a law making it mandatory for all girls, like between 13 and 16, to get this Gardasil shot, you know, from the big pharma, that actually these shots can harm you, but it's supposed to keep girls from getting this human papillomavirus, HPV, which is genital warts, on their cervix, which supposedly causes cancer. But, you know, the thing is, it was making it mandatory that all girls had to get this shot because it was some kind of a sweetheart deal with his one of his assistants and the drug companies who he had connections with, and get some money out of it, whatever it was. So, brothers and sisters, the places that you think are safe are not safe. There's only one place that's safe, and that's in Jesus Christ. The only safe place from the New World Order is in Jesus Christ. To be in Christ, to be born again, to be filled with the Spirit. As it says in John chapter 1, Jesus, to those who believe on his name, to them he, Jesus, gave power to become the children of God, or the sons of God. John chapter 1. So the Lord Jesus Christ is the only one that can make us children of God. He's the only one that is able to deliver us to the uttermost and save us to the uttermost. You know, the word salvation includes deliverance, freedom, liberation, all of those words that we use in America, liberty and all that stuff. We are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable. They can't alienate us from our rights. It comes from our Creator. It's only through the Creator, the Lord God Jehovah, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Lord God Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth, the God of the Bible, not Allah of the Quran, but God of the Bible, the one and only Most High God, El Elyon. He's the only one who is able to save us and deliver us and give us true liberty and freedom. As Jesus said, you know, he told the Pharisees, they said, oh, we've never been anybody's slaves, which was a lie. They had been slaves in Egypt, their forefathers. Jesus said, anyone who sins is a slave to sin, but those whom the Son sets free are free indeed. So we're free in Christ. As Paul told us, if you're a bondservant to humans, if you're a slave in this world, you're the Lord's freed person, freed man. And if you're a master and you're a boss and you're a big rich man and you're a big king in this world, like those rich people, you know, that I've dealt with who fly in private jets and, you know, spit on little people and spit on the orphanages and spit on, you know, people that can't repay them, who can't return the favor. Everything they do is, you know, what they call pour pavor. That is the Lord's slaves, the Bible says. You know, if you're a rich, you know, a boss in this world, you're a slave, a bondservant of Christ. But we're all free in Christ, brothers and sisters. That's the only liberty and freedom you ever had. It's not the United States. It's not in the Constitution. The Constitution comes from, out of, that inalienable rights that we have endowed from our Creator. God bless you guys. I'll see you. God's making a way. I'll be in Seattle. By the grace of God, all those other places. I pass through Nashville. Lord willing, I'll be able to go there and stop. On my way to Little Rock, home to Seattle, as God makes a way. See you guys on the other side.